Hi everyone, my name is Krupa, and I'm a program manager in Visual Studio working on HTML tooling. In this video, I'm going to talk about how Blend's features can help you build Windows Store apps that work well across a variety of screen sizes, DPIs, form factors, and orientations. Let's get started. So to highlight our responsive features, I have an application open. It's called PickAFlick. And just for the purpose of this demo, I'm not going to go further into this application. I'm just going to stay at this screen for now. What I built this application on is a laptop. It's running at 1920 by 1080, a pretty high resolution device. And the DPI is at a level where there's no scaling that kicks in. And at that state, my application looks fine. I developed it. Let me hit F5 to make sure what it looks like. I am running it right now. You'll see everything seems to be okay. I can click on the app. I can notice more content gets loaded. Things are fine. But because your apps are going to be running on a variety of devices, on a variety of form factors, you can't anticipate that everyone will have the same kind of resolution or same kind of device that you have. And testing for all those various resolutions, making sure your app looks good across all those various devices, is a very time-consuming proposition. It's also very expensive. To make a lot of the testing easy, in Blend, a feature of Visual Studio 2013, we've added a new item called the Device Panel. We've enhanced it to support some of the new functionality that you can find with Windows 8.1 projects. So the first of all, by default, Blend runs the entire design surface at 1366 by 768 at 100% scale. Now, if I wanted to very quickly see what my application looks like across other form factors, I can hit the drop-down, and I can go ahead and select one of the many types of device form factors which we provided based on the most popular devices that we felt are going to be used by most people using Windows devices. So for example, I can see what this application looks like at 1024 by 768. Notice once I've done that, then design surface resizes to match the dimensions that I selected here. I can also go, let's pick a resolution that's like 2560 by 1440 on a very large screen. So I can see that my app resizes reasonably well, and it's a little small, but that's okay because I'm physically on a large device, and it's okay for that to happen. So now let's go and talk about some of the other features that our device panel provides beyond just the resolution and DPI. It's very common for your apps to be viewed not only in landscape, but also in portrait. And if I want to preview that, I can just click on the portrait button, and I can very quickly see how my app reacts when it's viewed in an aspect ratio where it's taller than it is wider. Go back to landscape to make sure things look fine. And in Windows 8.1, one of the changes that have been introduced is that your apps can actually be variable size. They don't have to be a fixed size. You're not limited to the number of apps you can have on your screen. If your monitor supports it, you can have multiple apps arranged side by side, and each of those apps can have their unique size as well. So to help preview that, those various edge states, as we like to call it, we gave you the ability to see what your app looks like when you have something that potentially takes up space on the right-hand side of the screen, or on the left-hand side, or in a case where you might have third-party apps on both sides. And what we allow you to do is very easily preview what the UI looks like across all of these various sizes. So, and here's where we're going to touch upon some of the features that go beyond just identifying the problems. We're going to look at what we can do to actually address some of them as well. So right now, I am simulating a state where I have an app that's taking up a large amount of space on the right-hand side. So my app, you know, sizes reasonably well. It's pretty simple. But as I start getting very, very small, notice that the logo starts getting cropped. It is no longer visible fully. It needs to be done differently. So the first thing I'm going to do is, okay, what do I need to do to fix it? The background, the way this logo is specified, is it's specified as a background. Let me go ahead and identify it in my live DOM, and go to CSS properties to just inspect what's going on. All right, so let me minimize the animation category, and you can see the two background images that essentially make up what you see here. So what I'm going to do next is go ahead and say the main logo looks fine here, but I'm really, really small. I want it to actually take up less space. So I'm going to put the size property on this to contains. Let me say contain. And notice when I've done that, the logo actually sizes itself properly to take up the available space, which is less than what it had before. So it looks fine in this resolution. But let me go and just see what it looks like in the other states. And here's a problem. I don't want this logo to actually get larger as the amount of available space to my app increases. I basically want it to stay fixed like it was initially, but ensure it is smaller when I get below a certain resolution threshold. And the way I'm going to do that is by using media queries in CSS to selectively activate some style rules at certain times. So let me go ahead and just undo what I've done so far, because I don't want the rest of the app to be affected for the case where my app is really sized really small. And let's go ahead and pick a size. As I'm resizing, you can see the current pixel size displayed to the right of my cursor. So right now I'm at around 500 and let's say 555 or 560 pixels. And what I want to do is when I'm at the 560 pixel mark, I want to change how the logo is actually sized. And so I'm going to do that by going to Style Rules panel and adding a new media query. I'm going to say add at rule. I'm going to say select add at media rule. And when you do that, you get a preset. You get a collection of presets that are the most common media queries provided for you. What I'm going to do is just select one of them and modify to say, I want my max width to be 500 and let's just say 560. I said 560. We'll keep it at 560. Hit 560. So when my screen size is lower than 560, this media query will become active. If you can see, right now it is, because my application is currently at around 572, it is grayed out and barely visible. But if I were to resize it smaller, you'll see that it now becomes active, and it's now going to start highlighting any rules that are placed inside of it. So first of all, I'm going to make this my active insertion point so that any new style rules I add will go inside it. And now let's go ahead and specify what exactly the style rule, what exactly will happen when the background reaches a size where the window is less than 560 pixels. So I'm going to create a new style rule. I'm just going to call this one home container. That's just to mimic the exact same name I had earlier. And just like before, I'm going to go to background category, and I'm going to specify both the backgrounds again. So home container, and let me just go ahead and ensure in my applied style rules list, I'm selecting the correct one. I'm selecting the one that is from default.css. So first thing I'm going to do is add a layer, add my background image. I'll do film strip, just like before, repeat it, and no worries here. The next layer I'm going to add is our logo. And this time around, let me specify the logo first. Main logo. I want this to be positioned above our content, and I do not want it to repeat. But what I do want to is for the size of it to be contained. So notice that now the style rule home container contains a copy of what we had before, except the size is now scaled down a bit. Let me make sure that this did not end up causing the rest of our app to behave oddly. Let me resize my screen right now. And notice that when I resize it, the home container style rule is only the one that is defined in default.css. And once I go below 560 pixels, you'll see that the media rule version of home container kicks in, and the behavior we want is identical to what we talked about before. So there you have it, a very simple way of being able to preview some of the various states that you wouldn't be able to do at runtime using your laptop. As you can see, Blend's ability to simulate a variety of form factors and display settings in real time allows you to ensure your app will look good no matter what device you use to view it. The device panel, combined with our excellent CSS media query support, makes creating responsive UIs really, really easy.